Well, the guys, Mercedes, lovely machine, SL500, arguably the one to have. And what a straight car this is as well. Two keys we've got there. Sorry, pointing the camera down. There we are. A couple of keys. Give her a turn. Hang on a second. Oh, do you need your foot on your brake or something, does it? Hang on a minute. Yep, you do. There you go. There she is. Now, the roof was working. No question about that. And we've got no flashing warning lights on there. As you know, if you know your Mercs, if there's a problem with the roof, they tend to flash up. There's nothing there. I've just shut this one down. And I've made sure that the cradle's in, and that appears to be an okay. Now, there was a new battery, I think, fitted on one side, but if you know your Mercs again, you'll know I think there's two batteries. And it's trying. It is trying, you can hear it trying. And then you get that reading on the dash there. Look, left-hand side, battery. So, personally, I think it wants the other battery changing. Because you can hear it trying. And obviously there's your spoiler, which I won't press that. Obviously, the wind deflector, should I say. That works. Well, I can press it a little bit. Yeah, there you go. So that works. Put that back down out of the way. But you can hear it trying. You can hear the motor trying. But you then get out of time or something, it reads on there with a battery. So I can't see that being anything drastic because it was working. Other than that, and apparently there's a very good guy, a friend of mine knows a very good guy in Harrogate when it comes to these hoods and the mechanisms and how they work. So I'll maybe suggest a visit to him. I think 9 times out of 10 it's lack of use, and with some of the green around in places and things, I think that's half the battle. So there we are. Anyway, engine wise she sounds as sweet as a nut. There's no warning lights on the dash as far as the engine's concerned. That's all exactly as you would expect it in there, underneath the bonnet and so forth as well. The sound deadening's there. Couple of little marks on the bonnet there, but they'll T-cut out. In fact, I'll get Rich to T-cut those out tomorrow. You can tell, you get your nail and they're just on the surface they are, so they're going to T-cut off. No drama inside. A little bit of wear on that bolster there, but other than that, pretty as a picture inside. Very nice. And outside, I'll give you a little bit of a wander around. Little bit of a mark there, that won't see cut out. I can feel it with my nail. Couple a little bit, just a couple of little chips on the bumper there. And here, you're gonna have to have a bit of a smart repair done on that little panel there where it's just touched something. Other than that, a little bit of greenery and bits where she's been parked up. Other than that, what a straight old car, a real straight old car. Stand back as well. They're a fantastic looking car. And she's been on private plates, which have now been removed, and she's on back onto an age-related 03 plate. But still look really modern, don't they? Still look a real modern car. So there we have it. And see what you think. If we don't get any joy, then I shall get the details of that guy in Harrogate and see if he can do the hood for us. And then we'll pop it through in July. We'll see how we go.